Major movement today on the city's parking plan. When paying to park, keep the change in the car. Good evening, I'm Mike Dartis.
And good evening to you. I'm Cherie Palello. Cincinnati City Council voted today to upgrade the city's parking meters. Curtis Fuller has all the details in tonight's big story.
It seems like a valuable asset for the city, in my opinion. Whatever makes it easier for people to get in and out.
One perspective from a person who runs a downtown business. And it appears the mayor and the council agree. Mayor John Cranley pushing a parking plan that keeps control at City Hall and not with the Port Authority.
There has been sort of this assumption that our city workers, our city employees can't do this right. And I believe they can. I just believe that we haven't prioritized it appropriately.
The mayor wants to upgrade and purchase additional credit card meters, hire enough meter readers to handle current hours of enforcement. No extension of hours on meters without council approval, and ensure the city maintains all legal authority over parking rates and enforcement.
The beauty of this is that we're not making a 30-year or 50-year decision.
Izzy's restaurant operator, Adam Geisen, says he just wants something fair for customers. It helps them, and it ultimately will help his business.
Yeah. We have a lot of people that come in and out for carry-out orders. So coming in, getting in and out of here, not using this all-day parking pass is great.
Now, I'm told this upgrade could have a price tag of roughly $2.4 million. So where is the city going to find that kind of money? The mayor says there is no intent to add debt. It appears the project can be funded by a surplus in the existing parking enforcement budget. Back to you.
Curtis Fuller live in our newsroom. Curtis, thank you. But don't think that you've heard the last of this meter issue. In fact, the mayor made it very clear today this does not end the discussion on parking. He says it only moves it forward for now.